गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम। सो टुडे विल गो फॉर ए न्यू चैप्टर, दैट इज चैप्टर नंबर 3, डाटा रिप्रेजेंटेशन। डाटा रिप्रेजेंटेशन इज द कंसेप्ट हाउ द डाटा इज स्टोर्ड और कैलकुलेटेड और मैनिपुलेटेड और प्रोसेस्ड थ्रू द सीपीयू और मेमोरी। That means whatever data we are entering or whatever be the data we are going to store, those data are in a natural format or in a general format. But the computer can understand the data in a format that is known as the machine format or binary format, or using the digit only zeros and ones, which is known as the binary numbers or binary digit. So each and everything that we enter into the computer, that must be converted into a sequence of zeros and a sequence of ones, or a combination of zeros and ones, so that the computer can understand this. But in fact, what is this zeros or what is this one? Again, there is no difference. Machine, if you enter 9, then it is nothing different than the number 1 or the number 0 or the number 7 or any number. For any kind of device who doesn't have artificial intelligence, it cannot identify any of the digit. So what happened over here? Whatever be the data we are entering any kind of characters, alphabets, special symbols, digit, each and everything is converted into some electronic or some electrical format, which is known as a electrical pulse or electrical signal. These electrical signals are of two type, one is zero, another is the one. Then collection of these electrical signals or collection of these electrical pulses are used to represent zeros and one, and each and everything in a computer is represented with zeros and ones. Okay, so whatever be the data we are entering, the data may be either number, or that is digit, or any kind of alphabet or any kind of special symbols. The digit like 0 to 9, collection of digit we can make any number. Special symbols like comma, full stop, semicolon, hash, at the rate, query mark, these are some special symbols. Or any of the alphabet like A to Z or A to Z, any of the alphabet we can enter as data. But these, all these things are represented with the number of zeros and ones. That is the concept of data representation. Now what happened here? First we'll go for the numbers or the digit. If you are going for the numbers, then the most commonly used number we are using as a decimal number. The decimal number is come from the word deca. You must know about deca, that represent 10. Like in your chemistry or in your mathematics, you must learn mono, bi, tri, tetra, penta, hexa. Okay? Likewise, deca represent 10. And the word decimal is come from the word deca. The decimal number system is containing of 10 different digit, that is 0 to 9. And this number system, the number written in a decimal number system, is represented with a base 10. It is represented with base 10. So the digits are 0 to 9, so that using this 0 to 9 digit, we can represent any kind of number. The decimal number system is a weightage based number system. Weightage based in number system in the sense, suppose for example we have a number system, we have a number 563. So in fact this 563 is there are three digits. It is three. It is in the unit place. 6 is the 10th place, and 5 is the 100th place. 5 is the 100th place, 6 is the 10th place, and 3 is the unit place. So each of these 3 different digit has its own weight of 10. Own weight of 10, in the sense we can represent the number like this, that is 5 into 10 to the power 2, 6 into 10 to the power 1, and 3 into 10 to the power 0. So if I writing this number like this, then what we get, that is 500, then 60, then 3. 563 is the number. Now from this, the most significant number is 500 and the least significant number is 3. The most significant or the most weightless number is 500, the least significant or least weightless number is 3. So what happened here, the 5 is known as the most significant digit, whereas the 3 is the known as the least significant digit. The same thing happened in case of a fractional number. Suppose I am writing a fractional number here, that is 25.73. Now what happened? This is the unit place and this is the 10th place, we all know that. And what about 0.73? If you forget about or you remove this 25, then the number is 0.53. So how we can represent the 0.53? That is 2 into 10 to the power 1 plus 5 into 10 to the power 0 plus 7 into 10 to the power minus 1 and 3 into 10 to the power minus 2. So that in this case, the most significant digit is 2, that is the NSD, and the less significant digit is this 3, that is 0.73. last 3 is the least significant digit. So this is how the weightage of a number can be specified or can be obtained. The same thing happened in case of a binary number system, which is understood by the computer, the number system consisting of only 2 digits, that is 0s and 1. That's why it is represented as base 2. That means anything we are writing in a binary digit, that must be enclosed within a bracket with base 2. That indicates it's a binary number. Now the weightage of a binary number is 2. Like here the weightage is 5. The weightage is 10 in case of a decimal number. Likewise, in case of a binary number, the weightage is 2. Suppose the binary number is 11011. Then what happened here? The number is 01234. That means 1 into 2 to the power 4 plus 1 into 2 to the power 3 plus 0 into 2 to the power 2 plus 1 into 2 to the power 1 plus 1 into 2 to the power 0. So likewise, the most significant bit here is this. And in this case, this is known as most significant bit, not the digit. Here, it is known as the most significant bit, MSB. Likewise, this is the least significant bit or LSD. In case of decimal number, it is known as MSD, LSD, that is most significant digit. And in case of this is known as most significant bit. because it is known as a bit, because each zero or a one is known as a bit. Either a zero or a known one is known as a bit. That's why either it is most significant or the less significant. That is nothing than either zero or one. That's why this is known as a most significant bit or the less significant bit. Next is the octal number. The octal number has eight digits, that is 0 to 7, and it is represented by base 8. It is represented by base 8. The same thing, the weightage of this kind of number is 8, and here we can have the least significant digit and the most significant digit. In case of hexadecimal number, it is represented as base 16. Here we have a twist, and the twist is that in this case we have 9 up to 0 to 9 as digit. Then after 9, the 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 and 15. The 10, 11, 12, 13 and 15, 14 and 15 are represented as alphabet capital letter A, B, C, D, E and F. So these are the four kind of number system. Now in this case, using this decimal number system, we can represent any kind of numbers, and using binary number system, we can represent any number into the computer format. So what is the need of this octal number and the hexadecimal number? These two numbers are looking like useless in case of a computer, because using number system decimal we can represent any number, and using number system binary we can represent any number in computer. So these are the different evolution of number system. Initially we have, I told you, at the time of your programming languages or language processor, initially the computer understood only zeros and ones. After that, of course, are invented. After that, your high-level languages are invented. So initially, there are only binary digits or the machine language that the computer can understand. Later on, what happened? The number system will be octal number system, because that time we don't have the decimal number system. Octal number system, because as I told you, these are nothing than some electrical pulses or electrical signals that carries from one location to another location for storing or calculation. So what happened here? Each of the wire, a single wire that may pass either a 0 or a 1. A single wire that connects from one location to another location can only pass either a 0 or a 1. So initially, when the computer was invented, at that time that they were using 3 wires for communication. So each of the wire either travel 0 or 1, either pass 0 or 1. So total number of combinations we have, that is 2 to the power 3 is equal to 8 number of combinations we have. And these 8 number of combinations are 0 to 7 as octal number. So at that time, initially when the computer was invented around 40s or early 50s, that time we are unable to make any kind of calculation with the number having 8 or 9 in that calculation. In any place if you have 8 or 9, then we were unable to calculate such kind of numbers. So what happened? Another temporary wire has been used. So now we have 4 wires, so this along with this 2 to the power 8, this temporary wire either pass 0 or 1. So at that time, if it is 0, that indicates 8. If it is 1, now in case of 0, it represents 8. In case of 1, it represents 9. So now we have a whole number system, that is the decimal number system. That the decimal number system in which we have complete 0 to 9 digit, but still there is a problem, we cannot calculate or we cannot manipulate any of the alphabet. So what happened here? Now this temporary line will temporary line was become permanent, and now we have able to represent 2 to the power 4 by the 16 different symbols, and those 16 different symbols are your 0 to 9 as alphabet and A to F as 0 to 9 as digit and A to F as alphabet. So this is how the number systems are evolved, or this is how the number system are developed throughout the years. But still there is a problem, because there are out of this 6 alphabet, we have 20 more alphabets in capital letters and 26 more alphabets in small letters, or many different symbols. So for representing all these kind of different symbols, nowadays we are using two kind of number system. One is known as ASCII and another is known as ISCII. ASCII and ISCII are the two kind of number system nowadays we are using. So later on we will learn about ASCII and ISCII. Now if the weightage, I am damn sure that it is not so clear for you how the numbers are converted or how the numbers are represented exactly. So in the next session we will learn how a decimal number is converted to binary, or a binary number is again converted to decimal, or a octal to binary, or binary to octal. After converting the digit, after converting the number, this concept will be totally clear. For that, up to the next session, try this number system, learn about this number system, just remember the basis of the number system and number of digit in a number system. When we go for the total conversion, then it will be completely clear. Thank you and have a nice day.